you get some breakfast?
No, I didn't. How are you?
I didn't sleep at all. Probably looked terrible.
No, you don't. You look beautiful. Sad, but beautiful.
I'm so glad you're here.
Me too.
Where could Victoria be?
Honey, I wish I knew. I've been up on the phone all night.
Did you talk to Jay?
No. He didn't even know she was gone until we told him.
I don't believe that. He knows more about Victoria than anybody.
So what should I do? Sweat it out of him?
I want you to find him, and I want you to make him tell you the truth.
I can't believe you had to spend the night in jail.
You can believe it.
Well, maybe that'll call your Uncle Vince.
No, you're not calling Vince.
Look, you may not have another choice.
Did you hear what I said, Nancy? You're not calling Vince, all right?
I should have taken shop class instead of music appreciation. Necessity is the mother. Okay, Kathleen. Look alone now.
I'm in charge. Look, I'll handle it, okay? Hi.
Hello, welcome to Frenchman's Reef.
My name is Detective Adam Corey. I'm with the Bay City Police Department.
Bay City?
That's right. We need some information on one of your guests.
We have lots of guests here, sir. You want me to remember a certain one?
You wouldn't forget this one.
This woman is royalty.
So you would have had to have made advance preparations.
She comes from a small country named Tankier.
Except she's American. She has dyed, bleached, blonde hair.
I know of no such guest.
She's lying.
Kathleen, she's not.
Look,
lying.
I didn't come all the way to the Virgin Islands to listen to this. Where is Kath?
Kath?
Yes. And Cecile, that cow owes me an explanation.
Look, I told you I will take care of it.
Look, Cecile obviously paid this woman off.
Calm down.
Look.
We traced a call from this hotel.
I'm not lying. I've never heard of the Queen of...
Tankier.
Right, well, she's never been a guest in this hotel.
Okay, I tell you, maybe you could just tell me who's registered in room 606.
That I can tell you. It's Dr. Lachine.
A doctor? Well, Cecile West supposedly coming to Bay City for medical treatment.
Well, perhaps this woman, this queen, was a patient of his.
Kathleen, please, you tell me to calm down. You're going to get a fist in your face.
Look, is this how you're going to act the whole time you're down here?
Yes, until we find Kath.
I wonder if Robinson Crusoe got his start this way. Without you, my love, all of this will have been for naught. So don't leave me. Okay, Kathleen. I'm on my way.
I'm gonna break this up.
Look, will you stop it?
Why?
We're all in enough trouble as it is. I don't want to get the local authorities on our tails.
What do they mean? Nothing. Nothing. MJ, you went against orders to come here. Are you in trouble? Are they going to do something to you?
Me? The pride of Bay City PD? You kidding? As long as you don't break down that door, I'll probably get a commendation for this.
You cannot demote MJ.
Watch me.
Why?
She's just like anybody else around here. Just because she has a degree in psychology doesn't mean she can't walk a beat.
She hasn't done anything wrong.
She got on that plane against orders.
Yeah, she was working on Cass's case.
There is no case. She's grasping at straws.
I don't see why you're so mad about this. She's been working like a dog. Look, she's done the whole Lawrence file.
You won't be so loyal after you've been covering for her for a while.
I don't mind.
Great. See that guy out there in the hall? He wants to file some charges. You can begin by talking to him.
Why are you being so hard on her? You know what's going on.
She's supposed to have her butt behind that desk. That's why.
Larry, hi.
Yeah, wait, Nancy. I got this guy over here who wants to file a complaint.
No.
What?
Look, you can't talk to that guy.
I'm going to pick you up on that, but I was just told I have to.
Yeah, but you can't talk to him, Larry. That's the guy who had Jake arrested.
He's in jail?
Didn't you know?
His name wasn't on the arrest report.
Well, he is. And that's the guy who had him put there. He's a bartender, Larry.
Look, if I don't talk to him, somebody else will.
Look, Jake just wasn't himself last night. He got too drunk.
What'd he do?
He sort of got in a big fight with a guy at that guy's bar.
Did he start the fight?
Well, sort of.
That sounds like drunk and disorderly, at least. Could be assault and battery.
Oh, no.
Well, Jake shouldn't drink if it makes him mean.
Well, it wasn't his fault entirely.
But come on, nobody poured that booze down his throat.
Can you help him any?
What if this guy wants to press charges? Yeah. Sir, you want to come in?
About time you got around to me. What's his girlfriend doing?
I'm just his friend.
I wouldn't want to be friends with that guy.
Look, this kid doesn't even have a record here in Bay City. Nancy here says that he's been having a lot of problems, and last night he wasn't himself.
Yeah, that's right.
That just breaks my heart.
There's no chance of you dropping these charges.
No way. Not a one.
All right, I want you to go to room 16, fill out this. I'll come in and take your statement.
This better not take too long. I still got to clean up my bar.
Oh, Larry, what's Jake going to do now?
Well, the judge is probably going to set bail for
$5,000.
$5,000? Yeah, Jake's going to have to come up with $500 bail money.
Where's Jake going to come up with that kind of money?
Well, he should have thought about that before he started this fight. My hands are tied.
Yeah, well, thanks for trying, Larry.
Nancy, look, this is the real world. If Jake doesn't get that money, he's going to have to spend some time in jail.
Oh, great. I guess I got my work cut out for you, then. What time is it?
It's 10:30.
We're gonna stand here all day?
Maybe we could get a search warrant.
It'd take hours.
Open up, you crazy!
Police!
Adam, you really think that's gonna do any good?
Hi.
Have you been here all this time?
I was sleeping. Who are you?
We're looking for the Queen of Tankeer and a man named Cass Winthrop.
What's that got to do with me?
Look, we know he was here.
Could you just pipe down a little? I got these headaches.
I don't care about your headaches here. I care about Cass Winthrop. Now, was he here?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, was he sick? Is that why he was here?
I'm going back to sleep.
I'd answer the lady's questions if I were you.
Why?
Police.
Oh, I thought you were just making that up.
Now you want to answer the questions? Look, you already know that's not going to work. Ladies?
Hey, wait, you can't do this.
I think we already did.
I'm getting real tired of you, pal. So why don't you just tell me what you know about Cass Winthrop? Now.
Underestimating me.
They locked him up? Why?
It's kind of a long story, Mom.
Well, tell me about it. I got nothing but time.
Yeah, well, Jake doesn't. You see, he needs $500 bail money or he has to stay in jail.
Who told you that?
Larry.
You talked to Larry already?
Yeah. He says the only way Jake can get out is to make bail. And I already called Rachel.
Rachel's in Chicago to showing, and Mac is with him.
Yeah, I don't suppose you could.
Oh, honey, every dime I've got is tied up in this place.
Yeah, I know. Well, I guess I'll get somebody else some other way.
Hey, you know what?
What?
I'm proud of you. You're a good friend.
Some friend. If it weren't for me, Jake wouldn't be in this bind, huh?
Well, you didn't get him plastered.
I know, that's what Larry said, but I broke up Marley and Jake.
Oh, come on, they must have had problems in the first place, and nothing could have broken them up.
I guess, but if I hadn't gone to Marley...
You're not the only one to blame for this. Victoria Love was right in there pitching.
So Vicky gets the assist, and I get the hit. But I'm the only one who can get Jake out of jail right now.
Hey, what about Vince?
Jake doesn't want Mr. McKinnon to know.
There is no way you can keep something like this from Vince McKinnon.
Yeah, I know, but I am not going to be the one to blab. I learned my lesson, Mom.
One can only hope. I just had an idea.
What?
What about Michael Hudson?
Hey, you think?
Well, it seems to me that he is a good man in a tough spot.
Kevin. Come on in.
Thank you. That'll
Thanks.
Be all.
Sit down. I've been up all night.
Did you find anything?
Nothing. Oh. Look, I checked everywhere from here to Chicago. She didn't check into a hotel. She didn't use the phone. And no one has seen her rental car.
What are you going to do now?
I'm having her credit cards traced.
Oh, good.
But that takes time. I'll let you know as soon as I hear anything.
Okay. Look, you want a cup of coffee or something here?
No, I have to go. Thanks anyway. I'm going to go down to the police station, just make sure Vicky didn't show up on an accident report.
Look, you don't think...
No,
I mean, we would have heard something...
I'm just checking.
Miss Union, yes, sir. Miss Brittany, she heard you were here. She wondered if she could see you for a minute.
Look, just
Are you looking for her, Catlin?
Just tell her I don't have time right now. Thanks.
Oh, well, if you're through with all this, I'll...
Thank you.
I wonder what Brittany wants with
Callum. Oh,
Bridget, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Miss Dodge. Yes, I'm so worried about Miss Victoria.
I shouldn't have snapped at her. I shouldn't have snapped at her.
You're right.
But she understands me. She understands that I'm worried about Victoria.
Donna, come on. That's not an excuse.
Oh, I know it's not an excuse.
Wait a minute. No, I'll get it.
It might be something about Victoria.
Hello.
Is it Victoria?
In jail.
Victoria.
I know you think this is weird, Mr. Hudson, my coming to you like this, but you see, Jake wouldn't be in this mess if it hadn't been for Marley and Victoria.
Michael, who is that?
Don't worry. I'll handle it, okay?
Victoria in jail?
No, it's Jake.
Jake?
Yeah.
I told her he was no good.
Look, I gotta get down there.
Why?
Because I am going to bail him out.
Michael, that boy has caused my family nothing but trouble, and if he's stupid enough to get himself arrested, let him sit in jail.
Right.
Just find out about Victoria first.
Mom, you are a genius.
Oh, he said he helped?
Yes, he did. Soon it's going to be all over and Mr. McKinnon will never know.
Mr. McKinnon knows now.
You do?
Well, I'm about to. You're going to tell me, right? No.
It's Jake.
What about Jake?
He went into Chicago last night to see the Cubs play, but he was supposed to be working
here. The Cubs don't play at night when they're at home. There are no lights in the stadium.
Nancy, you better tell him.
Mom.
He has a right to know.
What is it about me? Nobody wants to tell me anything. Katie and MJ run off to the Caribbean, and now this.
Nancy.
Oh, Mom, please.
What about Jake?
He's in jail.
Jail? What? Why?
He got into a little fight. No big deal.
A fight? Is he all right?
He is. Mr. McKinnon, I'd really appreciate it if you'd talk to Jake about this. I don't want to go on any further.
Well, I'm going to. And right now.
Boy, when he finds out Jake was drunk and then he's going to have a fit and Jake is going to kill me.
You're very protective of Jake all of a sudden.
Yeah, well, Marley's gone. Jake's in jail. Nobody seems to give him a break.
Michael, what are you in here for? I'll let you know when I'm ready to get out of here, okay?
Right.
Okay, Jake. I guess I'm not one of your favorite people.
You guessed right.
The judge says you're going to need $500 to bail you out of here.
Not from you, I'm not.
Look, I know you had it rough. Just get your stuff together, I'll bail you out.
So I can either stay in jail or I can take your money.
Well, it looks like that, buddy, yeah.
All right. Thank you very much.
All the arrests in the last 24 hours.
All right, thanks. You didn't have to get him yourself.
Who else is going to do it?
Oh, Ewing's out and McKinnon's
I finally got a lead on that body at Gallant's.
Oh, Caroline, I didn't know you were here.
I just came by to look at an arrest report.
Well, I wouldn't have yelled it if I'd have known he was here.
Okay, what'd you find out?
Yeah, where'd you get?
We got the guy's name. We found his passport. He's from Switzerland. But the last visa stamp indicates that he was in Tankier for 6 months prior to that.
That's where Cecile is. And those women that were following Cass.
Yeah, it's quite a coincidence, huh? For such a small country, they sure sent a lot of people to Bay City.
Could be significant.
Oh, come on, you know it is. Now, do you think MJ is grasping at straws?
Kathleen, that's not going to do any good until we know what we're looking for.
Oh, look, he's not going to talk. Look at him.
We'll get him to talk.
When? Look, Cass was here. Maybe he had something in the drawer. Maybe he sat in his chair.
Maybe.
Look, I to him now. I cannot stop.
So you're a doctor, huh?
Yeah.
You got a license.
What do you care?
Look, if you don't start talking, I'll fix it so you never practice.
You don't have any power down here.
Look, but I'm friends with the guys who do.
Listen, you quack.
MJ,
if anything happens to Cass, Kathleen,
yes. Calm down, okay? Calm down. And then we'll get Dr. Lachine to talk. Because if he doesn't, he's going to start spending these beautiful tropical nights in jail.
It's up to you, pal.
What makes you so sure that I treated this queen or her friend?
He called us from this room.
When?
Yesterday. We traced the call. We got a positive voice ID from the police lab. Cass Winthrop was in this room.
Which means that the queen was with him.
We know she was. I heard her voice.
Say, come on. What'd she do? Pay you off?
Who?
The queen, Cecile.
What's this queen bit, anyway?
Okay, she's a short, pudgy blonde.
Well, she's not really pudgy.
Hey, wait a minute. Has she got, like, a nice tan and lots of curly hair?
Oh, so you remember now.
You know, I think I do.
You know you do. You don't exactly have a thriving practice here. Show him the pictures.
I think you've been wasting my time, Doctor.
Well, it was that knocking on the door. It confused me.
Look, I've confused you if you do not look at these pictures.
Oh, yeah, I know these. Yeah.
Oh, good. Well, why were they here? Was it Cass? Was he all right?
Those things are so relative. Look, was the Queen your patient?
I treated the Queen. Now, that would make a good journal article.
Look, why did they come to see you?
Why not?
This isn't exactly the Mayo Clinic.
Let's go get the local.
Where were they staying?
I don't know. My receptionist didn't remember to take that information down.
Let's get the local authorities. We're wasting our time.
Sit down.
Doctor, you look like you'd like to have a drink.
I could use a little eye-opener.
That's too bad. Because we're going to stay right here until you start remembering something that'll help us find Cass Winthrop. To Papa.
All right.
Okay, Winthrop. Where are you? Day is at 11:30.
Other world.
So, you got the door open, but I know you didn't leave because I would have seen you. Come on, Winthrop. Don't play these games. Same time this time, just like it has been every time before.
How do you like it, LaRusso? I'll tell Kathleen you said hi.
This better be very good. That Queen you were talking about, she brought in a guy for treatment.
For what?
I don't know. When I examined him, there was nothing there.
Where were they staying?
I don't know, and that's the truth. Don't call the cops, okay?
Look, where do you think they might have been staying?
Well, not on the island.
Why do you say that?
Well, because she was talking about bringing him here to find a doctor.
Could they have come from one of the small islands?
Come to think of it, she was talking about me billing her at this place called Paradise Cove. I said I only took cash.
Paradise Cove?
How many people were with them?
You mean besides him and the Queen?
Mm-hmm.
There were these two big guys and these two good-looking women.
Okay, let's go. I think we're wasting our time here.
Thanks, pal. You've been a real friend.
Hey, I'm just dedicated to serving my fellow man.
Let's go!
Yeah, could you patch me through to Paradise Cove? Yeah, hi, Your Highness. It's me. Yeah. Everything's going according to plan. Yeah, they should be there, I figure, in about 24 hours.
This is the break we've been needing. It proves the CEO was involved.
Yeah, right.
You know, Cass Winthrop could be in a lot of danger.
Sally was in the parking lot the night that guy was killed.
I know.
She kept saying...
Sally had nothing to do with that.
Unless Sally saw that.
I get it.
Maybe whoever did this, whoever killed...
I can get off that case, I can get onto this one.
Why don't you let the police handle this?
Look, I was convinced that it was an accident.
But what if it was a murder?
We'll find out. You see, I've been living with this every day. So I need answers. Come on, Jake. You can sit there and nurse your pride. You can let me help you.
You've helped enough, don't you think?
What is that supposed to mean?
Turn mine against me, Michael.
You know that's not true, Jake.
Guard! Mr. Hudson's just leaving. Guard!
Fine. I'll go. But before I go, I got one question for you.
Fire away.
Were you lying to me when you told me you didn't know where Victoria was?
Vicky is a liar, Michael, not me.
Okay. Thanks. By the way, I hope you like it in this place. Personally, it's not my style.
Oh, I'll be okay, Michael.
Yeah. Jake!
Vince, what are you doing here?
You're doing in jail. You all right?
Yeah, I tried to give him the bail money, but he wouldn't take it.
Well, good for him. He's learned not to take anything from a love.
Vince, come on.
Vince, I am not a love, and I never will be.
Well, I don't trust the loves or anybody connected with them. I learned that the hard way. Come on, let's go. I made you bail.
You don't have the money, Vince.
I said, let's go. Get out of our way.
Vince, I want you to know I am not a love. As a matter of fact, I have come here to try to put right all the things old man Love did wrong.
He's going to restore the love's name. That's a laugh.
You ready?
Come on, Uncle Vince, let's go. Forget about Michael Hudson, right?
Yeah. He can do whatever he wants for the love. Still won't bring back my Mary.
Takes a lot of time to get sprung from jail.
Yeah, well, this much. You know, Carter's been waiting for over an hour, Mom.
Here they are. Here. Hi.
Hey.
I didn't mean to tell him, Jake.
He knows. I told him.
It's all right.
Really?
Everybody's been pretty worried about you.
Yeah, well, I'm okay.
Well, great. Carter's waiting over there for you. I'm going to make you two a special lunch all by myself.
Dude. Hey. I hear you were a guest of the city last night.
Yeah, well, I'd really rather not talk about it if you don't mind.
Okay. What do you want to talk about?
You.
Huh? How's everything going with you? Getting ready for the big move. Lily took Thomasine and the baby out there to look for an apartment.
It's hard to believe you're moving to Los Angeles.
Hollywood. Sometimes I can't believe it.
I'm gonna miss you, man.
I'm gonna miss all my friends. But this is such a great chance.
Yeah, it's UCLA. You can't turn that down. You're a Bruin.
Wish my dad could see it happen. This is like one of his biggest dreams.
No.
You know, sometimes things are going so well, I get scared.
Carter, you deserve it. I mean, you've had your share of bad breaks.
Things are going to get better for you too, Jake.
Well, I hope so. They sure don't seem like they can get any worse, do they?
You know, that's what I like about you, Jake. You're such an up kind of guy.
Did I say I was going to miss you? Am I going crazy here? Did I say that?
That's what you said.
Is that your own money?
Well, I wasn't going to have Michael Hudson post his bail.
Well, he must have wanted to do it.
Listen, he can just keep his lousy money.
What's the matter with you? He's a very nice guy.
Well, 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 I see the Bickersons are at it again.
Do you believe Jake Paul Getty here? He's too good to take a favor from Michael Hudson.
Isn't he back yet?
Renting a helicopter is not like renting a bicycle, Kathleen.
Just next door.
Hey, Adam wants to get going as much as you do.
Here he is. Did you get it?
We leave in 15 minutes.
Oh, 15 great. Minutes?
Yeah, they're servicing the chopper now.
Oh, this is such a waste of time. Cecile could have Kath anywhere by now.
Look, it's not a waste of time.
What's that?
It's a map of all the outer islands. The guy that I got it from said a lot of these islands aren't even inhabited.
Well, where's Paradise Cove?
Well, he didn't know. And, Gosh, I'm not even sure it's on this map.
Maybe it's just a private beach somewhere. Look at all those islands.
I know, this thing is peppered with them.
How are we ever going to find Cass? Victoria.
Don't ask me.
She must have said something to you.
Well, I really was in a good mood to listen.
Oh, I'm so worried. Miss Donna doesn't tell me anything.
You know what? You shouldn't just forget about Miss Donna and Vicky, too, for that matter.
Oh, you don't mean that.
Really, I don't care if Vicky's dead.
Oh, Jake. Why don't you stop talking like that?
Why don't you do it, Bridget? Why don't you let her get away with all this? That's why she's garbage now. You know that?
Oh, Jake. I know that Victoria hurt you, and I know you're disappointed by Miss Miles. I didn't ever, ever expect you to talk like that to me.
Bridget.
What's the matter? What's wrong?
Everything.
I'm really sorry about telling
you. You know something? I don't even know why you bother with me.
Don't be silly.
I mean, I'm just garbage, you know that? Just garbage.
Jake!
That's it? You're not going to talk to me all day?
I talked.
Oh, in words of one syllable.
So?
So what do I have to do to get this over with?
Apologize for jumping all over me.
I did that.
Then tell me, what is this hang-up you have about the love?
It's a long story.
It's about your wife, isn't it?
What do you mean?
It's because your wife was working there as a servant when she died.
Listen, don't talk about my Mary in the same breath with the Loves.
I'm waiting.
Donna, I didn't want to tell you until I was sure.
Michael, you've been keeping secrets from me, and I don't like that.
Okay, look. You remember that investigation that I was carrying on?
What investigation?
The one into your personal finances.
Yes, what did you find?
Well, you remember when we thought it was really strange that Swiss bank was holding up the money?
Yes, it's horrible. My entire family fortune is in that bank.
I was checking up on that.
And what did you find?
Your money is being held illegally.
What?
Yeah, that's what that phone call was about.
You can't do that to me. That's my money.
Donna, what are you doing?
Hello, could you please give me the number at Camp David?
Oh, yes. Donna, please.
Michael, I'm going to handle this.
No, would you let me handle it?
I want you to be honest with me. That's what I want you to do.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anytime.
Get that money.
Oh, I'm sorry. The door was open.
Did you find anything?
Yes. I think I know where Victoria is.
There's about a half a dozen Paradise Cove.
Fine, right, we'll here. See all of them. We're just looking for a private villa.
Okay, great. Come on,
great.
Let's go.
Kathleen. Here I come. So long, suckers.
Hometown, Lassiter, Pennsylvania.
I didn't think she'd go back there.
Here's the name of the motel where she spent the night.
Well, how'd you trace it? Through the credit card?
Yeah.
Oh, this is good work.
Listen, I'll go to Lassiter if you want.
No, 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 it's okay. I'm going to take it over from here.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you. This is such a relief.
Yeah, well, I just hope I have as much luck in my next case. All right, look, I'll see myself out.
Okay. Hey, where are you going?
I'm going to call the airline. We're not going to drive there.
No. I can fly us there.
You'll fly us in a plane?
I got a little two-seater. I can fly us there in a couple hours.
You can fly an airplane all by yourself?
Yeah. You afraid?
No. I'll do anything to find Victoria.
Good.
Listen, good. I don't say this very often.
What?
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I know how much you loved your wife. You don't want to talk about her? It's okay with me.
Thanks.
I know you got a lot on your mind. I shouldn't have pushed you.
That's true.
But you haven't been very fair about Michael Hudson.
Well, now I'm going to say something you won't hear very often.
I can't wait.
I'm too grouchy.
To say the least.
Katie and MJ have been gone almost a whole day.
You haven't heard a word from them?
Probably means they haven't found out anything. Not a clue.